Launching a new product can be an exciting yet challenging experience, and you're going to need a product launch strategy. You might have a great idea, but bringing it to life and getting it in front of the right audience can be a complex process. In this episode, I'll be walking you through four stages that you can use to build your product launch muscle. Whether you're an experienced entrepreneur or just starting out, stay tuned for some valuable insights on ways to build momentum for launching any new product. Welcome to the Leveraged Business Podcast, where we believe business success is about working smarter, not harder, leveraging your time and expertise in ways that fit the digital age you and your clients live in today. I'm your host, Jay Allison, author of Leveraged Consulting in the Digital Age and founder of the iSuccess Business Academy. And every episode, I'll be sharing insights into how you can apply the power of leverage to grow your consulting, coaching, or other expert services business and create true freedom and independent success with mindset, marketing, and money model breakthroughs. Because when you get leveraged, the sky's the limit. Let's go for it. Hello and welcome to this podcast episode all about building your product launch strategy. And when I say product, I mean something you build and sell, be it a physical product, a digital product, a course, a class, a service, or a program. Now, when you hear the phrase product launch strategy, that maybe sounds a bit ominous. And for anyone who's seen those big hyper launches, that's not what I'm going to be talking about here. So fear not, you can start with tiny, soft little launches and build your product launch muscles one step at a time. Today, we're going to go through four stages from idea to offer and gain some momentum from some initial seeding and internal promotion. No matter how big your circle of influence is right now, we all have networks, contacts, and social media followers, right? If you consider the whole 6 degrees of separation, the idea that all people are just six or fewer social connections away from each other, then you can appreciate that people know people. A chain of a friend of a friend can connect any two people in a maximum of six steps. Launching a new product can be an exciting yet challenging experience. You might have a great idea, but bringing it to life and getting it in front of the right audience can be a little bit complex. Now, if you've followed me for a while, you'll know I'm not a fan of big hyper launches. I much prefer a rolling enrollment approach. Perhaps that's because I come from the consulting background where consistent flow of leads and clients on demand is more the mode of operation than a lot of big campaigns and launches. And for my iSuccess programs, I've always tended to do soft launches and enrolling a small group at any given time. For instance, the Leveraged Business Accelerator, because it isn't a curriculum-based program. It's a structured process for strategic review, planning, and coaching for each client, from where we create a customised 90-day action plan. Because of this format, I open up spots when I know I can give my coaching clients the time needed between other commitments. And that's a product launch strategy that's worked really well for me personally because it avoids the big peaks of work to run hefty campaigns that enroll high numbers of clients at once. It means I maintain a more consistent work-life balance, which has always been my goal. So in this episode, I'll be walking you through four types of launch and talking about general good practice, my experiences of launching, supporting launches, and being a participant in launches. And then in part two, we'll go through 10 critical steps that's going to help you create a solid foundation for your product launch success. Let's dive in. Four stages that build your launch muscles. In his product launch formula, Jeff Walker talks about four types of launches that are progressively validating the product you want to take to market. I really like this approach. It not only fits with the steps you need to take to ensure your product launches successfully, but it means any of us can get a new product into the marketplace, even if you don't have a big list or a ton of people rallying around for you. Taking an iterative approach to product launches helps you validate the idea and build momentum. That's a great place to be first if you're looking to launch big at some point. Many of the big players will always seed an idea and validate it first, modify it, or pivot based on that experience before going large. A successful small or soft launch is what gives you the confidence to invest time and resource into the bigger successful product launches you may have seen around the digital arena. So the four launch stages you can build to, or types of launch, as Jeff Walker presents it, are the seed launch, the internal launch, the joint venture launch, and the evergreen launch. I'll describe each of these briefly here first, which will illustrate how anyone can easily get going and go about this quite gently. And then we'll dive into what I believe are the crucial 10 steps to creating, promoting, and launching in the broader sense. We'll do that in part two next time. The first type of launch is the seed launch. The purpose of a seed launch is to test your product idea with a small group of people before you invest a lot of time and money in developing a product. During a seed launch, you'll offer your product to a small group of people at a low price in exchange for feedback and testimonials. Once you've validated your product idea through a seed launch, the next step is to create a more developed version of the product and do an internal launch. An internal launch, or soft launch as I describe it, is more my style. It's to create your product and promote it to your internal email list. During an internal launch, you'll create a buzz around your product and offer it at a special introductory price for a limited time to your email subscribers. Note, I didn't say discounted price. I never use that term. And if you want to know why, reach out to me and I'll share my point of view. I rarely go beyond doing an internal launch. Anything more just isn't what I want to do in my business. You may understand why when I go through the other two stages in a moment. Even staying with the internal launch stage, if you have a successful product launch campaign, you can simply rinse and repeat every so often, sometimes just once a year for a big intake. Then you focus on supporting the people who you've just enrolled. This is how I launch the Leveraged Business Accelerator program, where 2 to 3 times a year I'll open up spots. That doesn't mean you don't change anything and rest on your laurels, so to speak. Even with just keeping to internal launches, I keep changing up the messaging and offer to make sure I'm attracting the right fit people who are my ideal clients to work with. If things are going well, you may want to expand promoting your new product or program beyond your direct email list, say sharing it on your social media channels or on a podcast. In this case, you'll need a little bit more than just a sales page. You'll want to encourage them onto your email list for the next launch by offering something super useful that's relevant to the product you're launching. So say you're launching a new online course about product launches, which I'm not, by the way, but product launches is certainly something I've coached people through. A compelling lead magnet would be something that helps someone take the first step forward. It might be a 10-step guide and take the form of a short ebook, a video training, or maybe a 3-day challenge. Promotional content does not always have to be part of a launch campaign. When I cover the 10 essential steps to successful product launches in the next episode, I'll also be sharing a 10-step checklist. It kind of illustrates the point of how building your list means you have more people to launch to. The next stage, assuming you're getting good take-up of your offer, is to organize things so that other people can promote your product or program too. This is the third stage, the joint venture launch. A joint venture launch is a collaboration between you and other business owners who have a similar audience to yours. During a joint venture launch, you'll partner with these other business owners to promote your product to their email lists in exchange for a commission on sales. Many people use this approach, and their JV partners will offer some associated bonus to get their contacts to buy from them rather than from others, particularly if there's lots of people promoting the same thing. Some only do it with an inner circle group of partners, while others set up a sophisticated, complex affiliation system with a leaderboard and all kinds of bonuses to drive the competition and higher lead generation and sales. You may have noticed I very rarely do JV partnerships, mostly because being half and half in the consulting world and the online marketing space, my list of individuals for online programs is relatively small. There are some programs that really complement what I do, where the person specializes in doing a particular thing well. For example, Jeff Walker with his product launch formula, Danny Inney with his audience building and hybrid courses, Lisa Bloom with her Selling Through Story program, and Melinda Cohen with her Coaches Console business system. My advice, if this is new territory for you, is to start with people you know and trust and who know and trust you. Follow their JV protocol and experience the structure and flow for yourself. And finally, there's the Evergreen launch. An Evergreen launch is a type of launch that runs continuously, meaning that your product, course, program, or service is always available for purchase. During an Evergreen launch, you'll create a system that allows potential customers to enter your sales funnel and receive automated emails that will ultimately lead them to purchase your product. It's not really a launch at all. It's more just a rolling campaign. This can work really well, but it does miss some of the buzz of the scheduled launch strategies. Many of the big players in the launch space will only open doors once a year, which brings a scarcity and urgency to their enrollment campaigns. So if that's the broad grand scheme of things, what are the steps to getting going with launching your new product? Well, you need to create and implement a product launch strategy. Launching a new product can be a challenging and daunting process, but it can also be incredibly rewarding. And overall, creating, promoting, and launching this new product takes a lot of effort and planning, but you can get started easily by taking it one step at a time. In part two, I'll be taking you through 10 steps that can help ensure that your launch is successful, whether it's a seed launch or a bigger venture. Launches of any kind is simply a campaign run across a particular time frame and will really set your business up for consistent list building, revenue flow, and long-term growth and success. People who skip the critical foundation steps struggle to create a product that meets the needs of their target audience and is positioned effectively in the market. To launch a new product successfully, you do need to create a solid plan. It's important to remember that not every launch will be a massive success, but that's okay. Failure is an opportunity to learn and grow and to make your next launch even better. So don't be discouraged if your first launch doesn't go as planned. Use what you learned to make your next launch even stronger. Remember to stay focused, stay organized, and stay connected with your target audience throughout the process. We'll continue this in part two next time around, which will be a much longer episode because I'll take you through 10 essential steps for successful launches. See you then. Ciao, ciao for now. Thank you for listening to the Leveraged Business Podcast. Want to create leverage in your business? Did this episode provide some insights and ideas to be thinking through? If so, subscribe so you get alerts when the next one's released. If you want to learn more or would like help and support with building a leveraged business that achieves true freedom for you, then head over to jallison.com/podcast to find all the resources and links that go with this show on my website and to join our iSuccess community. And if you're enjoying our content, it would be great if you could pop into Apple Podcasts or the app you listen from and leave me a rating and review. Everyone makes a difference to improving our rankings. So thank you if you've done that already. I appreciate you. So hey, that's it. Thank you for listening. I hope you've loved this episode and have some great takeaways to be thinking through. I wish you a pleasant, productive, and profitable week. And I'll see you again next time for another episode of the Leveraged Business Podcast.